If you're new to the channel, welcome. If you're not new, welcome back. Happy New Year's, everybody. I hope you guys had a great holiday season. Everybody was safe. Everybody was happy. That's my hope for you guys. But today I want to take a look at our very first project for 2024. Now, what we're actually going to be building is a car sales website where you can create vehicles, you can edit, update all the CRUD functionalities when it comes to dealing with these vehicles. And we are going to be using Breeze for the authentication. We're going to take a look at what that entails as we go through the series. Can we go ahead and start a quick walkthrough? We'll go ahead and create a new user. I haven't changed anything about the authentication, so all the pages don't really have any logo or anything like that. It's just very, very basic. Go ahead and register, and you can see you've been taken back to the dashboard where you are logged in. And then we have two navigation links up here, which is the dashboard, the normal dashboard. That's all it is. I didn't change anything about this either. But if you click that, you can go to the vehicles page. And since we don't have any vehicles yet, we just see this image right here, right? And if you go over here, you see we have a name, Nadia Dickinson. We have a profile where we can go, and all of the authentication stuff that comes with Breeze is in this file. So in terms of changing your password or dealing with deleting your account, you can do that in here as well. There's also a logout button where you can do that. And we'll be taking a look at all of these different things later on in the series. Let's go ahead and try to create a vehicle so that we can see what we're working with. As you can see here, there's a form where we are dealing with images. We're going to upload an image for those vehicles, as well as a description, make, model, all that good stuff. So let me go ahead, fill that in. We'll also add a choose file. We'll pick a vehicle. And we also have an image uploader, like a preview thing here. Go ahead, create. And as you can see, there's also validation on here where we can pick what size the image is going to be. So if it's higher than 5,120 kilobytes, we're not going to allow people to upload that image because it is too big for the specifications that we're creating. Let's go ahead and try to pick another one. I'll go ahead and pick this one. And then we'll go ahead and create. Great. As you can see, we have a little flash message up here with the year, make and model, and all that stuff is in here. And it also has been created. So you can see we have a nice big image of our vehicle that we just are creating. We have a price, and it was listed by Nadia Dickinson. That's the name. We also have edit, delete, and another button to go back to the vehicle index page, as well as a brief description of the vehicle. So you can go ahead, delete or edit. And as you can see, we have the image here, and you can go ahead and change it if you want to. But for now, I'm just going to go back to the vehicles page. And then we have an explorer because we're using all of the public functions within the controller so that you can see what they do, how they work, what they're used for, etc. Again, we have the delete button. We have the back to vehicles. Once we create or edit it, it'll be taken back to the show page. If we go back to vehicles, you can see that there is now a vehicle count up here where you can see one of our vehicles. When we have more, it'll fill out the rest of this page. We're also going to be dealing with some sort of pagination as well. I haven't decided on that yet, but it is something that we can do. One more quick thing that I want to show you is if we go to the show page, which typically will show the ID, but we have created UUIDs for this instead of using the ID. We've also done the same thing for the users, and we'll get into that again, as I said, when we get to that in the series. But hopefully now this will give you an idea of what we're building, what we're going to try, and to just kind of learn a few more things as we go along. If you are enjoying the content, please go ahead and click that like button, as it really does help out the channel. Here's a video YouTube thinks you'll like, and here's a playlist to follow along. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.